I'm going to show you how to make some Thor Mjolnir lightning using PowerDirector and some of my favorite video effects from big films. Links to the video effects I use in this tutorial are in the video description. It's time to shock your viewers. I have two clips on track one of a dude flexing with Thor's hammer. Now, for the first clip, we want to show lightning come into the scene. So we need to move our playhead to a point right after he lifts the hammer. And now we want to drag the first electricity clip that we're going to use to track two. So I'm going to hold my cursor over it, hold down my left mouse button. I'm going to drag this right down to the playhead. I'm going to place my cursor at the end until I see these two arrows, hold down my left mouse button, and I'm going to drag this in to trim it. Now we want to make some adjustments to the lightning. So I'm going to double left click on this to open up the PIP designer. We want to make sure that we're on the advanced tab. And now we want to move our playhead to a position where we like to see the lightning, get a full view of it all. Now I want to rotate this so that the lightning is coming from the other side of the screen. So I'm going to go to rotation and I'm just going to type in the rotation I want. You can go ahead and use your cursor, put it over this line here. Once you see these two arrows, you can hold down your left mouse and you can rotate it that way if you want. I'm going to change the scale. I'm going to bring it up a little bit. And I'm gonna position the lightning right on top of the hammer here. Place my cursor on this crosshairs, hold down my left mouse button and drag it to where I want it. You can make any adjustments that you need as well using the arrows or typing in the parameters that you want. And now we wanna go ahead and change the blending mode so that we can go ahead and take some of the black out of the lightning. So we're going to change it to screen. And now we're done with this. So we're going to go ahead and click on OK. And next we want to go ahead and add some smoke. We're going to move the playhead to a point a bit after where the lightning starts so that the smoke can come on a little bit after it. And now we're going to go to the clip of the smoke. I'm going to hold on our left mouse button and drag it down to the playhead. And then we'll go ahead and trim this in. Now we want to make some adjustments to the smoke as well. So we're going to double click on this clip, open up the PIP designer. And we're going to go ahead and select a place to place our playhead so that we can see the lightning and the smoke. I'm going to change our scale and bring this down a little bit. And we're going to place the smoke right over where the hammer is. So once again, you can place your cursor over this crosshairs and move it where you need it. Or you could type in the parameters. And we need to go ahead and add the screen blending mode again. And now we'll go ahead and click on OK. And the last thing we want to do for this one is add a glow. So we're going to use the laser. I'm going to place our cursor over it, hold on our left mouse button. And we're going to drag this right down underneath the electricity. Now we're going to trim this back a little bit. And we want to move it back right to where the glow comes onto the screen. And then we'll go ahead and drag this over. Hold on our left mouse button. Drag it over so it's back underneath that clip. And we'll place our cursor at the end. So we get those two arrows and we can trim it and make sure that it ends at the same time as the other clips. Now we want to double left click on this clip. We'll move our playhead to the position that we want. And we'll change the position. Make sure that we put it right over the
hammer again. So place your cursor over the crosshairs. Move it to where you need it. Or you could type it in. Then we'll go down to blending mode. And we'll select screen. And we'll click on OK. So that's everything that we need for the first clip. Now we're going to work on the second clip. So we're going to drag this electricity clip down to track two underneath the second clip. Place my cursor at the end, hold down my left mouse and trim it. Make sure it's the same duration. Now we're going to move the playhead to the beginning of the clip. And we're going to double left click on it to make some adjustments in the PIP designer. And we want to go ahead and change the rotation. You can place your cursor over this curved arrow until you see the two curved arrows, and then you can rotate it. I'm just going to type in the rotation that I want. Then you want to go ahead and change the position. So you can place your cursor here until you get in the crosshairs, and you can drag it to where you want. I'm going to go ahead and type in the parameters that I want. And now we want to go ahead and change the blend mode to screen. And now we need to use keyframes to make the lightning stay on the hammer. So we're going to make sure that our playhead is at the beginning, and we're going to go ahead and click on the position keyframe. And then we're going to move our playhead until we get to a position where we feel like the lightning is not on the hammer anymore. And then we can go ahead and change the position to make sure that it's on the hammer still. And it'll create a keyframe there. We can move our playhead to the next position. And continue changing the X or Y position to make sure it stays on the hammer. Then once your keyframes are done, you can go ahead and click on OK. And next we want to add some smoke to this environment. So we're going to go to the same smoke clip that we used before. We're going to place our cursor over it, hold on our left mouse button, and we're going to drag it underneath the other electricity. We're going to trim this. I'm going to double left click on this clip to open it up in the PIP designer. We will move the playhead to a position we want. And we can go ahead and drag it into position. Or we can type in the parameters. Then we'll go to blending mode and we'll change it to screen. And we'll click on OK. Next, we'll add a glow. So we're going to go to the laser again. Hold on our left mouse button, and we're going to drag it right under the electricity. And we're going to trim this in once again to a point where the glow shows up on the screen. Drag this over, and we'll trim the end. Now we'll double left click on it to open up the PIP designer. And for this one, we want to bring the scale up a little bit. And we want to place this over the hammer. And then we want to go to blending mode and change it to screen. And now we want to use keyframes to make sure that the glow stays on the hammer. Once you're done keyframing, go ahead and click on OK. So we're going to go ahead and go to this blast. I'm going to left click, hold on our left mouse, and drag it right underneath the lasers. I'm going to go ahead and trim on the end. We'll double left click on it to open up the PIP designer. And we want to move our playhead to a position where we can see the blast and everything going on. And we want to make sure that we got it in the right position, so you can drag it or you can type it in. And then we'll change the blending mode to screen. And we'll click on OK. Now we want to add a bit more electricity to, you know, fancify things a little bit. So we're going to go to this 04 electricity. Going to hold on our left mouse button and we're going to drag it right underneath the blast. We'll go ahead and trim the end of it. We'll double left click on it. And now we want to move our playhead to a position where we can see the lightning effect that we just added. And we'll bring the scale down and make it a little bit smaller. And we'll position it so that it looks like the lightning is going around him. And we'll change the blending mode to screen. And we'll click on OK. Now we want to add some more lightning to make it look like lightning's actually coming out of the individual. So we're going to add this other lightning effect here. Hold on our left mouse and we'll drag it underneath the other lightning. And we'll place our cursor at the end to trim it in. We'll double click it to open it up in the PIP designer. And we'll move our playhead to a position that we want so that we can see how the lightning looks. And we're going to scale this up a little bit. And we'll move it so that it looks like the lightning is emanating from the individual. And we'll change the blending mode to screen. And we'll click on OK. And now we want to add some debris to the environment. So we're going to go up here to this large scale. Going to hold down our left mouse button and drag this down underneath the electricity. I'm going to trim it in. We'll double click on it, open up the PIP designer, and we're going to change the blending mode to screen, because there's not anything else we need to do on this one. And we'll click on OK. And now we can go ahead and click the home key on our keyboard, and we'll play this back, see what it looks like. I knew that would spark your interest. If you want to fire up some mystical multiverse magic like Doctor Strange, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.